Jeba, can we clarify the many misconceptions that are parading as Hinduism, such as polytheism, idolatry, caste system, holy cow, legendary stories passing off as literal truths? There's so many misconceptions and mistruths about Hinduism. Please, could you share some light on this?
Indeed, it's nice to clarify these issues again and again, because our public somehow are still kind of caught up with a lot of kind of misinformation. Let me tidy up. First of all, the greatest challenge the Hindus face is that we are a polytheist tradition, many, many gods, and we also, Shiva, Vishnu. In reality, we have never been a polytheist tradition. We have always been a very mature, very ancient, very kind of well thought out system of thought called pluralism, saying there are many different ways of making spiritual progress. And we may, in a way, make our spiritual progress by focusing on kind of super personalities that thrill us, that kind of attract us to the idea of spirituality. It may be Vishnu, it may be Shiva, it may be Mother Goddess, it may be Ram, it may be Krishna, it may be Hanuman, Ganesh. We like to personify the idea of spirituality as supreme, as we are like superhuman personalities that we can relate to. Otherwise, how do we relate to this idea of spirituality? It's very subtle. So we always recognize a variety of different ways of engaging with the idea of spirituality, and this has been presented as pluralism, plural ways to be spiritual. There is nothing to, you know, undermine. It's a very, very mature system of thought. It allows people of many different religions to coexist. It allows people of the same religion to coexist peacefully, because this is your way, this is my way, this is how I become spiritual, this is how you become spiritual. And even suppose you are a secular person, don't believe in religion and God, nothing wrong with that. You are unfolding spiritually in the mode that suits your own temperament. You are looking after your family, you're looking after your personal needs, and this is how you are slowly unfolding spiritually. So never vilify any different approach you might adopt to make spiritual progress. This is the marvelous thing at the heart of our tradition called pluralism. The world has to embrace this idea if they want to stop fighting in the name of religion. That's the first issue, not polytheism, pluralism. The second issue that they really kind of keep raising again and again, and Hindus are caught up as well, they say, Mr. Lakhani, why do we worship images? Idolatry. They think that worshipping images means worshipping objects, you know, like marble and stone and wood and so on. Look, we have never been, idolatry means actually giving magical property to material things. We don't do things like that. We're simply saying, as we operate in the world of the finite, the only way we can relate to deeper vision is to use some kind of finite tools to relate to deeper vision regarding reality. We just recognize it. We do it in physics and maths. In maths, things are very subtle, so we produce all these squiggles, you know, x squared, you know, differential equations. Wow, all squiggles. These are symbolic ways of trying to relate to deeper dimension to reality. Science does it all the time. And the Hindus say, we are doing it also, and we use this lovely colorful symbolism, either we call them symbols of Hinduism or images that we use without any hesitation, without apologizing. These are the different ways we relate to our spirituality, using very finite objects, nothing wrong. We are not worshipping objects, we are using finite objects to think of something higher, deeper regarding reality. So if somebody says, you idolatrous, tell them, look, every field, every, even mathematics uses idolatry, uses symbols to relate to deeper vision. Otherwise, you can't do your equation. So nothing to be frightened about. Symbols of idolatry simply say, no, we don't worship objects. We use objects to worship the infinite God. The objects are very finite, very limited, and yet we are using them to relate to deeper vision regarding nature of reality. So always come out robustly when somebody uses the word polytheism or idolatry in your face. The next issue they keep throwing in our faces again and again, they pull it out of the Manusmriti. It's an outdated scripture which was suitable for a thousand years back. We already discarded it. It was the rules, codes of conduct adopted by society over nearly 1,000 years back. We rejected it. Since Ramanujacharya, it has been rejected. So we don't subscribe to it. In that particular textbook, there is an idea that you got a hierarchy, a hereditary caste system. It has nothing to do with modern Hinduism. And Hinduism is a living religion. And we discarded this idea. Yet they said, no, you must say it's Manusmriti. Tell them, keep the Manusmriti to yourself. We have outgrown it. We already discarded it. But if you want to hang on to it and make big fuss about it, good for you. But this is not Hinduism. So again, the idea of caste, when it comes, just fire back straight away, what I just told you. Okay, so the other issue they say is sometimes when they want to make fun, they say, Mr. Lakhani, do you call the cow your mommy? I said, you're my boy, listen. You see, when I explain to you why this cow is not just ordinary animal, but a very special animal, you will also call cow your mommy. I said, let me explain. If you look at the history of human beings, until 10,000 years, we were hunter-gatherers, all of us, whether Hindus or non-Hindus, all hunter-gatherers chasing around with spears and killing animals and eating them, rushing around, you know, near the seaside and killing fish and eating and surviving. That's how whole of humanity was surviving, as hunter-gatherers. The word means hunt, or sometimes gather some fruit or nuts and eat it and survive. That's how we were surviving for thousands of years. Homo sapiens, mean thinking humans, appeared on earth about 70,000-80,000 years ago, and for the first 60,000 years they were hunter-gatherers, almost like animals. Only about 10,000 years ago, humanity discovered throughout the world, discovered a superb animal called this holy cow, this kind of gentle cow, which allowed human beings to stop being hunter-gatherers, running around with spears, settle down, you know, have a, you know, home, have a family, have children, learn languages, become civilized, and wait for your crops to grow, because your ready food supply is the cow giving you milk. So give dry grass at one end and milk comes out the other end. So you are safe for 1 year until your crops grow. Otherwise you can't be farmers, you'll die next morning. So in order for humanity to move from being hunter-gatherers to becoming much more kind of civilized, settled down, farming, starting civilization, starting language, is this gentle animal called the cow. That is why we give it special reference, special reverence. I think whole of humanity should pay tribute to the gentle animal that has allowed human beings to become civilized. That's the idea of the holy cow.